It's Friday night, and you're on your way to meet a friend, Tassie, for a few drinks at the pub. But you're on a bus, stuck in traffic, and as a result, you're a bit late. So, you message Tassie to let her know you're going to be late. Heya, how's it going?
Cool. Where are you at?
I'm still on my way. Gonna be a bit late. Are you at the pub yet?
Yeah, I'm in the pub.
Okay, did you notice that? You said, are you at the pub yet? But Tassie said,
I'm in the pub.
Why did you say at, and why did Tassie say in for the same place? Is it at the pub or in the pub? Who's right? Well, they're both right. Here's why.
When we talk about 3D, three-dimensional spaces, we often use in. That's why we say things like in the office, or in Cairo, or in the Amazon, when we're talking about the Amazon rainforest. When we talk about things on a line or a path, then we often use on. That's why we say things like on the beach, or on the road, or on the Amazon, when we're talking about the Amazon River. And when we talk about points on a map, we often use at. That's why we say things like, the train stops at Central Station, or I'll meet you at the fountain by the park, or she works at the Museum of Modern Art.
That's why, when you were talking to Tassie on the phone, you said, are you at the pub yet? Because for you, sitting on the bus, in traffic, the pub feels more like a point on a map, a destination. So you used at. But when Tassie answered,
yeah, I'm in the pub.
She did so because for Tassie, the pub is no longer an X on a map. It's a real physical three-dimensional space. She's in it. So she used in.
But what about on? Well, as we saw before, we often use on when we're talking about things on a line. That's why we drive on the road, why Australians have barbecues on the beach, and why Camden Town is on the Northern Line. But remember, this all depends on how you look at it.
That's why you can say you're having a barbecue on the beach or you're having a barbecue at the beach. I mean, when you're on the beach, how do you think about it? Maybe you're seeing yourself as someone on a long line of sand that we call the beach. You're on the beach. Or maybe you think of where you are as just a point on the map, just somewhere in the city. An X on a map, at the beach. Remember, these aren't rules, but they are guides. Choose the preposition based on how you feel about what you're describing. If it feels three-dimensional, it's probably in. If it feels like something on a line or a path, it's probably on. And if it feels like a point on a map, it's probably at. However you look at it, have fun with Tassie at the pub. If you ever get there.